Hello, I'm Scott Bryson, and I'm an applications engineer with Texas Instruments Position Sense product line. This video is an introduction to AMR sensors and describes the fundamentals of how this type of sensor operates to enable various sensing functions. AMR is an acronym for anisotropic magnetoresistance. Specifically, anisotropic here refers to the fact that the material in the sensor has a physical property that changes depending on the direction that is being measured. In this case, the resistance of the material will change depending on the direction of an incident magnetic field. Due to the higher sensitivity of the device and its simple construction, AMR exhibits lower intrinsic noise than Hall effect sensors. The low noise improves the quality of the measurement, allows for a faster sampling rate of the sensor, and provides low latency output signals needed by automated control loops. In the nominal case with no magnetic field, or when the field is aligned parallel to the direction of the current through the material resistance will be at its peak. As the angle of the field changes, this resistance will vary to some minimum value whenever the field is perpendicular to the current flow. Note here that rather than being sensitive to a vertical field component, AMR sensors detect fields that are coplanar to the sensor. With a rotating magnetic field that is greater than the saturation threshold of the material, the resistivity will oscillate twice per full revolution of the magnetic field. This is due to the resistivity of the material being unaffected when the field is parallel to the direction of the current, and then decreasing to a minimum whenever the field is perpendicular to the current. And both of these conditions are met twice per full revolution of the magnetic field. It is important to keep in mind that the direction of sensitivity of AMR sensors is parallel to the PCB, unlike many Hall effect sensors that only detect the field normal to the PCB surface. With an AMR sensor monitoring a horizontal field component, it is possible to create a few helpful output formats for a variety of applications. The first case is for creation of a low-power switch. AMR sensors typically require less current than Hall effect sensors, and can be set up to create an on-off output signal based on the position of a nearby magnet. If the AMR sensor is sufficiently saturated in the direction of sensitivity, an internal comparator detects the change in resistance and toggles the output of the device. This can be used to define the end of travel for a motorized shuttle, to detect the correct plunge depth of a piston, or even replace simple reed switch sensors with a contact-free alternative. Another powerful application of this technology is to use the sensor to generate both sine and cosine outputs. These outputs provide enough information to perform precision angle calculations with very fast response times. And this makes AMR particularly useful for angle encoding used in brushless direct current, BLDC, motor control. To enable angle measurements, this technology is typically configured into a Wheatstone bridge format, physically aligning the AMR structures as shown here with two parallel resistor dividers, improves measurement linearity, and creates a differential output that varies with the direction of the input magnetic field. If a second Wheatstone bridge is created with a 45-degree rotation, both sine and cosine outputs become available for an arctangent calculation. However, there is a limitation to the overall angle accuracy. Since the output responds at 2 times the rate of rotation, aliasing can produce an uncertainty in the actual position of the motor. For example, if we consider the output of a 3D Hall effect sensor, we would capture a single period on both the sine and cosine output, while with an AMR sensor, 2 periods are observed. If we calculate angle using the output pattern for each, we see that during rotation, there are 2 positions per revolution for any given output angle for the AMR sensor. Devices such as TMAG6180-Q1 and TMAG6181-Q1 help to overcome this by using an integrated 2D Hall effect latch. The latch output provides quadrature or turns count information that can be used to calculate an absolute angle of the motor. With the TMAG6180-Q1, the latch outputs are directly available. At each quadrant change during rotation, either the Q1 or Q0 output toggles, signifying a 90-degree rotation. Using the information available from these signals, it is possible to determine absolute angle across the full 360-degree rotation. A companion device, TMAG6181-Q1, replaces the quadrature output with a pulse width modulation turns counter. Once enabled, the turns counter increments or decrements at each 90-degree rotation interval. This allows the system to track relative angle position across the full 360-degree rotation based on the position of the magnetic field when the turns counter was enabled. The turns counter is particularly helpful in geared systems where the motor may turn many times before the target achieves full revolution. Additionally, this turns count function is available with a low power mode to track system changes while minimizing power consumption until returning to normal operating conditions. To learn more about AMR sensing using devices such as TMAG6180-Q1 and TMAG6181-Q1, click the links below to download the documents. Calibration of AMR angle sensors discusses the output format common to these devices, what error sources may be present in the system, and provides insight how to calibrate the sensor. Benefit of low power turns count in AMR sensing discusses how the turns count feature benefits systems that require low power angle monitoring, and position sensing in automotive door handle systems discusses the use case of TMAG6180-Q1 to monitor the position of a deployable door handle to enable position feedback controls. To learn more about AMR sensing, please visit ti.com/AMR.